Hey everyone, this is Sal Cangeloso from Geek.com, and I'm here with the new Lenovo ThinkPad Edge 13. If you follow the ThinkPad series, you'll know that this is a completely new series for them, and it's going to come in three different models: the Edge 13, which is a 13-inch widescreen, the Edge 14, and the Edge 15. So I think I already did the unboxing. I'm going to post that video first if I find it. Otherwise, we'll just have this one. So I'm gonna do a quick look at the system and get into some ThinkPad geekery for you. I'll be posting a review up really soon, so check back on geek.com for the full text review. I wrote a whole lot. So yeah, system's open right now, and right off the bat, we can see the new keyboard design. The Edge is going to be the first ThinkPad with a chiclet style or island style, whatever you want to call it, keyboard. Lenovo is calling this their contemporary keyboard because, in addition to using the isolated keys, they also switched the layout around. So what we have here is the F keys on the top row. They aren't primarily mapped to your F functions. They're primarily mapped to volume, mute, play, pause, fast forward, stuff like that. And if you want to get to F1 through F12, you have to hold down the function key, which is right here in the corner. A little bit of a change of pace, nothing too dramatic. And then we also have, try to show these. You could see the difference right here. These keys right here, they're kind of hard to make out, but you could see that right here, the page up and the page down. Sorry, page up and page down. Got those backwards. Anyway, those keys are they're half height, so that it's just a little click. It's not a full key press. But then you do have those easily accessible right above your arrow keys, and you don't have to worry about accidentally clicking them when you're trying to get to your left and right arrow, so they feel different. We still see dual cursor controls. Just like you would see on any ThinkPad, it's a little bit different of a click here. These are straight, they're not curved the way we've seen some other ThinkPads. Again, not a major deal. You could probably tell that. There you go. This is a glossy display. You could see that's some serious gloss there. So, again, the gloss, you love it, you hate it. And it's no option right now for that. It's also a 16 by 9 panel. So, everyone's still clamoring for their 4 by 3 ThinkPads, which died out. I think the last one was maybe 2 or 3 years ago. But now instead they're going from all 16 by 10 to 16 by 9. So the final resolution for this one in the 13-inch model is 1366 by 768. And then let's take a quick look at the new design. This is the Edge, obviously, and we see a gloss lid. So gloss lid. It's also available in black, and it's available in red. This is the first ThinkPad that's going to be available in a color, which is a really big deal. I mean, obviously it's just aesthetics, but wow, a ThinkPad in red, that's pretty wild. All the Edge models are going to have this band around here. It's just silver. It just looks cool. Or maybe you don't think it looks cool, but anyway. So they're going to have that around. That's going to be a distinguishing feature. This model also has a red LED right here, just like on the ThinkPad SL series. And then there's a red LED right here that is going to be on when you run the system. And those are the only indicator LEDs on the entire computer. So again, there's not a whole lot of lights shining on this one. Quickly, we'll go through the ports. And we see the lighting isn't great, but we see VGA, HDMI, Ethernet, USB. There's nothing on the front, there's nothing on the back. And then on this side, we see a card reader. That's a single mic slash headphone jack, basically a headset jack. Two more USB slots, and then this is a standard ThinkPad power connection. There's a little LED right next to it right there, and that is going to let you know if it's charging or not. There's that glossy lid. Again, I wish the camera was better. You can see that right there. I accidentally scratched this. So you need to be kind of careful with this gloss. This is not that kind of tough ThinkPad material. It is like a plasticky gloss. I think people might be better off getting the matte black if they're interested in having something that doesn't get any fingerprints or doesn't get too scratched up. But again, that's going to depend on your usage. And then here is the, just put it down. You can see the bottom, basically really plain. The main thing I wanted to show you here was this is the 6-cell battery. It's slightly extended, and it's going to push the laptop up to I think a little bit under 1.4 inches thick. So not that bad for a I think this system is 3.6 pounds with the standard battery and like right about at 4 pounds with the 6-cell. But the good news is that 6-cell is going to get your battery life to right about 7 hours, which is pretty solid. And now let's just really quickly run through the specs. I'll turn the computer on and we can see how long it boots in. So, okay, mark this time. So this computer is powered by Intel's U7300. It's a Core 2 Duo 1.3 gigahertz processor. This is going to be this build with 4 gigabytes of RAM and Windows 7 and 320 gigabytes of storage is going to cost, I think it's $899. The system itself starts at $599, but for that much, you're not going to get the Intel CULV processor. You're going to get an AMD processor. So the cheapest ones in the $500 and $600 range are going to be Athlon Neo X2 processors. And there, it's done booting. Oh wait, it's still going. It's almost done. So anyway, the cheapest ones are going to be the Athlon Neo X2 processor. And then if you upgrade from that, you're going to have the AMD Turion X2. The Intel is probably going to give you a little bit better battery life. But the thing with the Intel is you get Intel integrated graphics. With the AMD versions, you can get ATI, I think it's HD 3200 graphics, which might be a little bit better, but again, battery life is going to suffer. And yeah, it's totally booted. It was booted for a little bit before. This is running Windows 7 64-bit. And let's really quickly look at those LEDs. Then we see the ThinkPad Edge logo right there with the LED running. And then there is the LED on the lid. So yeah, there is the ThinkPad Edge 13. This is Sal Congeloso from geek.com. Thanks for watching.